Hello students, today we are going to continue our chapter, that is chapter 3, Jainism and Buddhism. So in our previous video we had studied main teachings of Jainism's first point, okay. So today we'll study the second point, that is 9 truth. 9 truths. So in our previous class we had studied first point as the 5 woes. Today we are going to study about the 5 truths of Jainism. So here students, besides the 5 woes, that is 5 woes we had studied in the previous class. So besides this 5 woes and other general doctrines of Jainism, Jains are expected to have the knowledge of the 9 truths here. Okay. So, according to Jain philosophy, the knowledge of these 9 truths is essential, and only renunciation to the shortest way of salvation. Okay. So, here renunciation means no longer have the want of something or a desire of making money, property, like that. Okay. So if we leave all these things, that is if we leave that we don't want any money or property, and so that time we can attend the salvation. Salvation means moksha. Okay. So this is the 9 truths. So here, according to Jain philosophy, the knowledge of these 9 truths is essential and only way for the salvation. Okay. So these 9 truths have central place in the philosophy of Jainism. So we'll see what are these 9 truths here. Okay. So first one is Jiva, second one Ajiva, third Punyam, Pap, Ashrav, Sanvar, Banda, Nirjara, and last one is moksha. Okay. So these are the 9 truths of Jainism. So first one is Jiva here. Jiva means living things. Okay. Living things means people here. And Nirjiva means it is non-living thing. Non-living thing means desire of house or other material, we can say as Ajiva. Then Punya is that what all good deeds we are doing. Okay, good deeds is told as Punya here. Then Pap is sin, all sin, that is murder or killing or thinking bad of others. Okay, so that is Pap. Then you can see Ashrav. Ashrav is also a good deeds here. Shanrav, Shanvar is a hindrance in the way of karma. Then next you can see Banda. Banda is a relation with our body and soul. Okay. So Nirjara. Nirjara is the destruction of karmas, and finally it is moksha. So according to Jainism, it is said that if we overcome from all these 9 truths, okay, then we can attain the moksha. Moksha means it is stop from the cycle of rebirth, okay, death and rebirth here. So next we'll see the doctrines of Jainism. That first one is three ratnas. So here doctrines of Jainism. So in that first we'll study about three ratnas. Okay. So Mahavira preached that the ultimate goal of man is to attain freedom from the worldly bond here, okay, and to attain moksha. So this, to attain moksha, a person has to follow the three ratnas. Three ratnas means three jewels, okay. Three ratna, it is also called as three jewels. So three jewels are right faith, right knowledge, then right conduct. So these are the three ratnas or three jewels. Okay, so these three jewels inspires a true Jain to have faith in the 24th Tirthankara. So who was the 24th Tirthankara? He was Mahavira. Okay, so you can see that to acquire knowledge from their sermons and to lead a good life. So next we can see second point is karma. So the Jains believed in the karma theory of Hinduism, and that one should be responsible for their own karma. Okay, karma or action. So good deeds alone liberate a man from the cycle of life and death. Okay, so according to Jainism, they believe that if we do good work, it will stop our cycle of life and death here. Otherwise what will happen? Again we have to take rebirth and come. Okay, so third point is equality. Mahavira laid stress on equality between men and men and women. So he preached a universal brotherhood, and he considered all men equal irrespective of their caste and creed. So when you see in Hinduism, there was too much of difference between men and women as well as caste and creed, isn't it? So that was not there in Jainism. So Mahavira believed that the virtuous deeds could achieve ultimate salvation or nirvana. Okay, salvation means moksha. So all living beings, from the tiny insects to the highest form of life, should be shown compassion. Okay, so that's why they say that in Jainism they should not even kill a tiny insect. Okay, so then only they can attain salvation. So next point, fourth point, we'll see. Eternal soul. So Mahavira believed that in immortality of the soul. Okay, that is Atma. He said that the body dies but the soul does not die. Okay, so eternal soul. Eternal soul means body will die whereas the soul will not die here. So fifth one is salvation. Like Hinduism, Jains also believed in moksha or salvation, okay, or the freedom of cycle of birth and rebirth. So this can be achieved only by leading a auspicious life, okay, so based on non-violence and self-denial. To attain salvation, it is necessary to practice three ratnas. Okay, so three ratnas of right faith, right knowledge, and right action. So next we'll see belief in penance. So Jains also, they believed in penance, okay, to die of starvation. Okay, so they believed in dying of starvation called Santara or Selikana, okay, and was considered it as virtue. So Jainism lays so much stress on severe penance that very few people could lead such a austere life. Okay, so this explains why Jainism had only few followers. So in Jainism you can see that they give more importance to penance. Okay, so by starving they used to die. Okay, so that's why you can see only few followers were there in Jainism. Okay, so students, today we'll end up this video here. So we'll continue this chapter in our next session. Thank you, children.